Let's begin with knuckles. Bring your chin to the chest. Begin to circle your head in either direction. Let your hands and your arms be in a relaxed position. And continue to circle your head at a pace that's comfortable. A lot of times as you're doing these neck rolls, there might be a particular line in the neck that you want to work. So feel free to hold that line and just breathe into it. Let yourself just stay in a relaxed position. Breathe more. A turn on your mat for a dragonfly pose. You're going to spread your legs out to the side without forcing them. Now here, as you can see, where Roxana is on a cushion and Andy's putting a cushion underneath his bottom, feel free to do that if your hamstrings are really tight. Fold forward, drop your chin to the chest. Scan your body. Make sure that your muscles are relaxed. Again, let your hands, your arms go wherever they naturally go. You want to work towards what we call this Goldilocks place, where you're not trying and you're not avoiding. The practice feels very simple, very easy.
See you, Ram, Jai, Jai, Hanuman.
See how some people are pulling the shin in close towards their right hip, and other people have the shin more parallel to the top of the mat. The left leg is straight, and you can round forward. Feel free to put props under the head, under the belly, maybe even under your right hip, if the hip is up floating off the mat a lot. Beautiful the practice is. Just a lot of time for you to be quiet and still within your own self. Breathe normally. Keep letting go. Keep relaxing.
Sita Ram, Sita Ram, Sita Ram, Sita Ram.
Take your time as you begin to slowly round your way out of the posture and move the way your body wants to be moving as you make your transitions. And just come to the left side. So same thing, you'll bring the left leg forward. The right leg will be straight behind you now. Be sure to use your props if you use them on the other side. Keep relaxing, keep letting go. And you'll notice for sure that the two sides of our bodies are often very different. So it's really important that you try not to make your body do what the other side did. Yin yoga is the practice of seeing what's there and allowing it to be there. And it's this awareness and non-attachment that helps us to be really real with our bodies and with our minds as well. This is so much about your mind. Let your belly relax. legs spread wide and the arms spread wide. Maybe put a bolster or a blanket over your belly, maybe even something over your eyes. Just rest for about a minute. If it's uncomfortable for your legs to be straight, twisting motion to the spine. As you exhale, you can drop your knees to the left this time and gently look towards the right. Again, let the arms naturally adjust. It's a beautiful heart opening posture. chest. And here, please take the knees very wide so the knees come up towards the armpits. You can grab above or below your knees. And take two huge breaths so that as you inhale, your belly gets huge, as big as you can make it. When you exhale, the navel comes back down. Rock up, take the knees to one side, and come into a tabletop position. And make your way onto your belly, or Sphinx pose. Elbows below the shoulders, bring the palms together so you create the shape of a triangle with the forearms. Look straight ahead and inhale. And as you exhale, bring the shoulders towards the ears and drop your chin to the chest. Now let go of the bottom. Let the glute muscles relax. Let the head hang. It's a wonderful pose for the lumbar spine, the low spine. Just be very passive, very much at ease here. If it feels uncomfortable for your head to be hanging like this, you can let the forehead rest gently on a block or maybe in the hands. As you practice yin yoga, you'll begin to personalize the postures. And as that happens, really trust that. Press weight into the forearms, lift the tailbone up, and stretch back into child's pose. So the sit bones come towards the heels, the forehead is on the ground, or working its way in that direction. So again, resting it on a bolster or a block or a blanket is perfectly fine. Take a couple more deep breaths here. Your legs can be together, or the knees can be separated. Begin to lift the tail up into heart-melting pose. So the hips stay directly over the knees. And you're going to stretch your arms out in front of you. Some of you are going to feel comfortable with the chin on the mat, and others with the forehead on the mat. Really feel this pose melting the heart open. Softening through the heart. It's a beautiful, beautiful pose for the lymphatic system. Thank you. up to a tabletop position. Again, move very slowly as you transition. Tuck the chin to the chest for cow pose. And then inhale, open up the heart and throat for cow. Arched back, and then exhale into cat. Inhale, look up to cow pose, and then exhale to cat. We're gonna come next into shoelace pose. Starting with your right knee on top of your left knee. You can come into it from a tabletop position with the right knee forward, tucking the left knee behind the right knee. That's a little easier actually for most people. Or you can come into it from a seated position. I'm gonna open up the heels, bring both sit bones on the mat, take a breath in. And as you exhale, round through the spine and just fold over your top leg. You could also do this pose on your back. You would grab for the shins or the ankles. Now looking into the hips is really quite an experience, so be gentle and kind to yourself. Know that adjusting in this position is part of the position, so your body will begin to open up, and as it does, you'll find yourself naturally adjusting. Just work with your mind here and take out any part of you that thinks that you have to do anything. Just breathe and feel into your hips. Once again, remember that if you get a tingling sensation in the hips, that means that blood is not flowing to that part of your body, so just readjust. Be as still as you can, as quiet and as calm as you can. Thank you. to come out of the posture, take a little break. That's perfectly fine. Listen and honor what your body is asking. The better that would be for you, just with yourself up, and we'll flow through that same sequence, but first taking a rest in farmer's pose. So pull the knees in, wrap your hands underneath the knees, and just take a couple deep breaths here. Try to get the breath to fill up the lower part of your back where your kidneys are. slowly come out of your farmer's pose and shoelace on the left side. So your left leg will be the top leg. Again, you can come into it from a tabletop position or from a seated position. This is a tricky pose, so if you're having a tough time with it, know that many people do in the beginning. And I must honestly say I've seen incredible things happen with people's joints in this practice. So hang in there, stick with it. Don't rush any of it. Just learn to be comfortable with all of it. Chin comes towards the chest, the head hangs down. Let your water just come to stillness. The whole practice of yoga is designed to help us master ourselves, master our minds. So just be with yourself and let things come up as they come up. There's no work that needs to be done. It's just letting go. this time with the left ankle on top of the right. Take a breath in, lift up, and as you exhale, Mane, bow in. Again, putting the forehead in the palms of the hands if you would like. legs can be straight or bent now. Stretch your arms up over the head. Take a deep breath in. And as you exhale, once again, pull the knees towards the armpits so the legs are open. And breathe so deeply that you can feel the pressure at the pelvic floor with an inhale. So huge breath again. So good for your body. Take all that oxygen in. Rock up. Now we're going to start to work into more of a yang energy. This is called dragon lunge stretch. So fold your mat in half or put a blanket or a towel underneath your right knee. Your left leg will come forward and you're going to roll forward so that you are off of the right kneecap. Your hands can be to either side of your left foot, or you can bring both of your hands to the inside of your left foot. Maybe for some of you, you'll even come down onto the forearms. You have to make sure that you are not over-efforting this one. There is a tendency to really go for it. You want to back away from that sensation. Drop the chin to the chest. This is a beautiful, beautiful pose for your digestion. It's an intense pose, so feel free to take a break too if you need to. Your mat up. first, it can feel so good to open up that mind, but back away and know that time will do it. You just have to be still. Your ability to be still will strengthen with your position for about a minute, breathing. And again, this is more of a yang posture. There's energy. You have to use your muscles to keep the legs up and the arms up. And this is what tonifies and strengthens your spine. In the practice of yoga, we measure health and well-being by the mobility in the spine, the part of the brain that drops through the body. So just stay with it, breathe. Each breath in the pose is helping you to stay strong and vital in your bodies. Very important work. Now come down and rest. Bring the opposite ear to the mat. Let go of your bottom. Take a couple deep breaths. Important that we really rest when we rest, really work when we work. But it's really the rest that gets us stronger. So make sure you're even resting during your work day. Lift your head up and turn it the other way now. And rest a few more breaths. Chest, push yourself into a tabletop position and into toes pose, broken toes pose. So you're going to flip the pads of the feet over. You can look at the video right here, the backs of the soles of the feet. And you have two positions you can choose from. The shoulders can be right over the hips. This is very, very intense. Or you can come down onto the forearms. What matters in the practice is that you really learn what is the right pose for you so that you can be still. Again, stillness, the relaxed muscles, and the time that you're holding the pose is what's bringing the change. This has so much to do with the steadiness in our mind. So make sure you're breathing here, you're staying in your body. Personal acupuncture treatment on yourself. You have opened up the lines of energy. We call those the meridians, the way that the energy flows through your body. It's starting to flow a little bit more smoothly now. And you can begin to feel that steadiness in your mind and maybe even in your heart towards the end of this practice. Stay in it for another breath or two. And then come into a tabletop position very slowly. Flip your toes over and we'll work into one of the counter poses. So you'll sit back on your heels, slide your hands by your heels and lift the knees up maybe. Some people's knees don't want to come up so you're not forcing. And then lift the heart up and if it's okay with your head and your neck, you can drop it back, but be very careful. Just a couple more breaths as you're stretching through the ankles right now. And then coming back, sitting onto the heels in rock pose. So a lot of pressure, the sit bones on the heels. And bring your palms together at your heart center. Lengthen your spine, a slight tuck to the chin. And inhale, sweep the arms up over your head. Exhale through your mouth and bring the palms through the heart center. Two more. Inhale, big breath in. And exhale. One more. Inhale, take all the breath in. And then exhale, press it out through the mouth. Keep the thumbs at the heart center. Beings live in peace and let it be that all beings